Our For Women in Science journey brings us back to those who graciously brought us together, UNESCO and the Fondation L'Oréal. I now have the pleasure to have with me Madame Audrey Azoulay, the Director General of the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, UNESCO, and also Monsieur Jean-Paul Agon, the President of the Fondation L'Oréal. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Madame Azoulay, UNESCO celebrated its 75th anniversary recently, and science was one of the highlights. So it seems now, for the first For Women in Science Festival, science seems to be quite high on the political agenda, and it is also squarely in the public's eye. So how do you see the UNESCO contribution to science, and especially to women in science, which is called for by the 30 women scientists that are taking the stage today?
First, it's a pleasure to participate in this festival because the issues we are going to talk about and the issues raised by these women are structural, are fundamental. So here at UNESCO, you mentioned we've celebrated our 75th anniversary, and the science, the S in UNESCO, has always been at the core of the mandate. UNESCO was built and was imagined during the war, and with this idea that we needed science to build peace, we needed international cooperation in science, and also we needed to take more into account the social impact of science, and today I would say its ethical impact. And this has led to many initiatives of UNESCO in science during this history, in terms of international cooperation on ocean science, on biodiversity, on major infrastructure like the CERN in Europe for nuclear research, or the SESAME in the Middle East, things like that. But what we see today, and you were right to mention that science is very high on the agenda, is that most of the challenges we face need scientific response to deal with them. It's the case for, of course, the climate disruption, the loss of biodiversity, also the ethical impact of big data, of technology in our world. And for all this, we need more investment in science. And our number shows that there is not enough investment in science. But not only do we need more investment in science, we need a more inclusive science, and we need more women participation in science. And here again, the numbers are very bad. Despite all our efforts, today, when you look at the number of the proportion of women among researchers, it's only a third, more or less. And this number is not increasing, really, despite all our efforts. When you look at also the scientists, the professionals in the field of AI or of big data, it's around 20% only, 2022. And when you look at the composition of the academia, the scientific academia around the world, it's around 10%. So we have a real deficit of women in science, and we work here to try and to lift the barriers that still prevent women participation in science. We do it through education in the programs or to facilitate education for girls in STEM. And we do it for now, 23 years with L'Oréal in a fantastic program that promotes women in science by giving more visibility to exceptional female scientists, but also to support young researchers in their field across the globe. So we combine our strength, those of L'Oréal and those of UNESCO, our networks, to encourage women into scientific careers. And this is something I think which is very important, and that we do across all our activities to try and, you know, have this gender equality dimension in everything we do. In science, it's very much needed. It's also needed in our normative instrument in science. We are discussing now in UNESCO an open science recommendation. The gender dimension is very important. Also another one on the ethics of artificial intelligence. Here again, we have an issue on that. But this program with L'Oréal has been a success, and we hear it from many of our laureates to encourage and also to give hope and to give young women this impetus to go into science.
Monsieur Agon, for Women in Science Festival gives a much needed forum now for the women scientists. They can introduce their discoveries, they can talk about their researches, but they can also share their thoughts about biases and also about the systematic discrimination that takes place in science and that stands in the way of gender balance in science. For you personally, what are the key messages that you take away, and also how do you see what actions need to be taken in the future that are crucial?
Yeah, there are several key messages, you're right. Well, number one is that this festival shows that these women scientists are just extraordinary. You know, what we have seen today is really extraordinary, the quality, the level, the ambition of these women scientists is fantastic. And it confirms what Mrs. Azoulay said about the importance of women in science. You know, women scientists can really change the world. And you know, we used to say that the world needs science and science needs women. And this is more true than ever. So that's the number one thing. It illustrates the importance of this battle. Number two, it shows also, as you said, that women are still really underrepresented in science, and it is just not acceptable. You know, why would we, sacrifice, or why would we do without women in science? You know, women have to be in science, and they can bring absolutely a lot. And as you said, there is still many barriers, glass ceilings that limit their careers and their developments. So that's, I think, very important. And in terms of what the critical action for the future can be, I think that number one, as Mrs. Azoulay said, we need to give more visibility to these women scientists, because we need to inspire the next generation. You know, we need to make young girls attracted to science, young girls confident that they can be successful in a scientific career. And sometimes they are not. Sometimes they are afraid that it's not for them, that science is not for girls. So we have to encourage them. Number two, I think also that we have to unleash the potential of women scientists in new disciplines. You know, we have made progress thanks to the great program with UNESCO, the L'Oréal Foundation and UNESCO in the past 23 years. You know, we have had 122 laureates, we had 3,800 fellowships in 110 countries. So we made a lot of progress and developed the presence of women in science, but it has been mostly in some scientific disciplines like biomedicine, biology, all these sciences, but there is still a lot to be done in other disciplines like mathematics, physics, nanotechnology, artificial intelligence, and all these disciplines are super crucial for the future. So we need to stimulate women in this field. And to finish with, you know, a different idea is that we think that we should also enroll men scientists, because, you know, by definition, we cannot revolutionize science, and we cannot make sure that women are more integrated in the scientific world if men are not helping. You know, it's true in science like it is in any other part of the society. So we have a program called Men for Women in Science, where we really try to motivate men to accept and develop and promote the careers of women in science. So it's a great program. We are very happy and proud to have this program developed with UNESCO, and we are sure that we are really contributing to a better science for tomorrow.
I hope so. It sounds like it. Thank you so much, Monsieur Agon. Thank you, Madame Azoulay, for these motivating, also open words. Thank
Merci.
You.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Yes, it is indeed up to us all to ensure a brighter future for women in science, because only if we reach gender balance in science can science fully respond to the ever-growing needs of people and the planet.